Hi. So we went out and bought a whole bunch of stuff on Force Friday.
Too much stuff.
Like too much stuff.
Okay.
Including a couple things we don't have yet, but that I will totally show off when we do. Like the Kylo Ren Force Effects lightsaber, which is gonna be so cool. I'm so excited. And the Sphero BB-8. We got both of those, and that was way more money than I feel. Whatever. No big deal. We're not Star Wars crazy. And I got this awesome shirt, and we thought we'd open some of our cool toys on camera. Sound good? Okay, let's do it. What do you want to start with? Okay. So this is a Hot Wheels die-cast new or first order TIE Fighter. I'll leave my phone down here so I can check out the preview and make sure I'm doing good. So this is pretty cool. Maybe I can get you guys an unglary view of that. That's pretty awesome. I'm gonna open it up and see what it's like. Do a series of unboxings for all of our cool new toys. This goes in the bottom here. Interesting, I don't know if you can see that. There's a square hole there on the bottom, and it's a round peg. I'm literally trying to shove round pegs into square holes. All right, so that is the first order die-cast TIE Fighter. That is really cool. I love the little antenna on the TIE Fighter and then the red coloring. That's really pretty neat. I have a Lego set of this coming in the mail, so I'm thinking about doing a stop motion when we build that.
Yeah, that'd be sweet.
It'd be really cool. So I'll just set that next to the camera there. You wanna open one?
Sure. Just show it off first.
All right. Oh god, I gotta get the scissors up there. So this is the Resistance X-Wing Titanium figure from the Black Series. That's pretty cool. I'm hoping it'll have the wings set up right. I actually have one of those already open, which is over there, which I will totally show off in just a second. Hold that, I'll grab the scissors. Because you're gonna need it for that one.
You could work on these if you wanted to while I work on this.
Oh, we do them one at a time.
It's fine.
I can do some tasteful editing if it turns out that it's kind of boring to watch us open stuff. Just try to open things like where people can see. Ooh, that's cool. Yeah, because I opened the first order Star Destroyer already, which holy crap, that thing is so cool. I'm trying to finagle getting the Lego regular Imperator Star Destroyer as a birthday present because my birthday is at the end of the month.
And it's free.
All right, so there it is. Kind of see that there. It's a really nice metal material, and then figure out how the S foils open. Oh, cool. The landing gear. I believe the landing gear flipped down. Down here on the bottom. See those landing gear. And then the S foils open, which is very cool, including the gaps in the wings, which is one of my favorite design features of the new X-Wing.
Is it weird that the stand is harder to get out than the actual ship?
No, that's probably not weird actually, but
they don't
wanna
care if you steal
close
the
the
ship,
landing
they care if you
gear.
steal the stand.
Yeah.
There you go. It's free.
It's free, and then I will once again be sticking
There's
round
actually
pegs
a
into
reason
square
for that,
holes.
did you know?
Because it stays in better or
Yeah.
something?
I actually learned that when I went to like a museum and they talked about shoemaking.
That is a pretty darn cool X-Wing right there, I think. And I'll put that next to my TIE Fighter. That's pretty neat. What's next? Well, we did buy a lot of stuff. All right, so another. This is the Titanium series of the First Order TIE Fighter, so I have one that's matching scale, though I'm not actually sure it is based on how big it is, because holy crap, it looks way bigger than the X-Wing. You mean scissors on those? Figure out how to open this bad boy. All right, there we go. And comes the First Order TIE Fighter. Very cool. Its antenna is a little different than the diecast one, which I find very interesting. One of the things I want to be able to compare the Hot Wheels diecast ones versus the Titanium series, because that'll be an interesting point of comparison.
Do you need me to pull them out?
No, you know what? I'll just
be smarter. You're so smart.
Be smarter than I am by dropping it on the floor. TIE Fighter down! Well, you know, Han Solo could shoot a TIE Fighter down with his blaster.
That's true.
I wonder if the First Order ones are going to be the same way, like, if that's going to be, like, a joke in the series, or they're going to do that, so. So that is... Oh, that is... So is it just me, or are the wings... Look at that. Are the wings gush-launched? Can you guys see that?
Yeah, they're definitely gush-launched.
Yeah, the wings are gush-launched. They don't line up, like... When you look at the wings straight on,
that's interesting.
They don't line up properly. The right wing is off from the left wing, and loose. I just adjusted it with my hands. All right. Well, at least I fixed it. So here you go. That's the Titanium Series X-wing next to the Titanium Series TIE Fighter. They're definitely not to scale. And interestingly, even though it was a few dollars less expensive, the Titanium Series has almost the same size of wings, but is wider and has a really different discrepancy in the model design from the diecast one. That's really interesting. I'll do some close-up shots of those in a minute so that you guys can see that a little better. These Titanium Series ones feel kind of cheap, I think. But, what do you want to do next? Alright, so... We did a really interesting thing. I was trying to get figures of a couple of different sizes, of a couple of different characters. I feel like I'm missing one. Like, where's... We have another Poe somewhere. Where did he go? Will you go check around the... Around the Peapod to make sure we didn't miss any. So the first one I'm going to open here, we have... This is small.
I don't see him.
You don't see him? Because I swore we had a second Finn, actually. That was on a cardboard back, like... No, he was in one like this. Like this size. But I swear he's around somewhere.
Unknown.
Huh. In fact, I know for sure we had him, I just don't know where he is.
I don't know if we
did. Well, we'll find him, and when we do, I'll open him up. So anyway, I'm gonna start with this guy. This is Poe Dameron's smallest figure. Which comes with, like, random... You know how action figures these days come with, like, components that you combine into various things to build some kind of a droid. This one builds, like, a blaster. But for me, the important thing of this is that this was Poe Dameron in his, flight suit. In his Rebel flight suit. Which is really, really cool. This card is really nice. This is actually a double card, on the thing, so it covers over the edge of the plastic thing so you can't slide it open easily, which ends up meaning that it prints really nicely and just looks really nice in general. So you have to kind of peel it up and off and ruin the beautiful card art to be able to get into it. But that's unfortunate. Yeah. Where are the sisters?
That's a good question.
They were right under you or somewhere.
There
they are.
Buried under the toys.
So I'm actually going to cut some of this art to get into the figure. Okay. Little instruction manual, probably for the combination. And then the cool part is that the combiner's also attached to the figures to give the figure something cool. So inherently, the helmet doesn't come off, it's one piece. This is Poe Dameron in his flight suit with his helmet on, which is pretty cool looking. I really like the slightly updated Rebel flight suits, though I do notice that they're still using the same Rebel Alliance symbol, so I'm wondering how that's going to play out in the movie, or if that's an error. And then he has like a jetpack or something. I don't know what it's supposed to be. Doesn't really say what it's supposed to be, but it's some kind of a of like a flying jetpack that like has turbines in it. So obviously he's like trying to suck his own arms into the turbines and like get them chopped off or something. I have no idea. But he's really cool. He also has a little blaster in his hand, which, and he's got a holster for the blaster right there too, which is really cool. That's nice that you could holster his blaster. His legs are a little stocky, but that kind of makes sense for the flight suit. They have a low crotch.
Is he? Yeah, he's cute. He's like an angel with his little
doohickey. Yeah, his little doohickey legs. Alright, what's next? We're going to open Poe Dameron number 2?
Yeah.
Alright, so this is a slightly... I think this actually figures the same size, but this is a slightly more expensive box set of the Poe Dameron. Comes with like a flight suit overhead or something, I have no idea. And then it has these other figures here on the back of it, which include First Order Flame Trooper, Finn Starkiller Base. That's interesting, I'm wondering what that means. That's the one we have somewhere. Boba Fett and Chewbacca.
The Rey we have is also Starkiller Base.
Starkiller Base.
It's, according to Michael, it's the First Order base.
It's called the Starkiller? Boy, I wonder if that's a coincidence or not. You know the significance of that name?
Force Unleashed
is his name is Starkiller. I'm wondering if they're calling it Starkiller as an homage to that, or if they're like gonna tie Force. Oh God! Of all the canon they could tie into the main continuity, can we not tie Force Unleashed, please?
Yeah, seriously.
Like that's the worst. All right, so this is Poe Dameron in his regular Rebel jacket, which is pretty fucking cool. He's got his rank insignia on, and he's got an awesome full-size blaster that he carries, which is pretty darn neat. And then it comes with this... I'm dropping things. Comes with this overhead piece that you can put on him as like a... I don't know exactly like what this is supposed to be, but is his head actually supposed to go in there? Head doesn't look like it'll fit in the helmet. Head's got nice articulation. Armor up, what it says on the front of the figure. You notice how his head won't, like...
Actually fit? Well, do me a favor and don't decapitate him.
That sucks.
I think it doesn't fit because of his hair, don't you think?
Yeah, can his hair come off?
I don't think so.
Well, there you go.
Trials and tribulations of action figures.
You can see that his head doesn't really fit very well. In fact, the breathing apparatus blocks his long, or his face, and his hair is the reason it doesn't fit. That's funny.
Whatever. He's cooler without it on anyway.
Yeah, he is. Alright, so this is our first of the large scale figures. I have at least one more of these, so I'm going to save both of those larger scale figures for last, because, or for near last, because they're freaking cool. So, let's actually look at this one before I open it. This is the Black Series, which is ironic in this particular instance. Trying not to get glare on the screen from the window. This is for Finn, John Boyega's character. And he's pretty cool. I'm gonna open him up. Packaging is really nice quality, like, you know, nice slide-out card and good packaging. I really like that. And then figure is tall and has good articulation. Looks really nice. I'm sad that I could only get Finn. Oh, that's gonna be loud. Instead, I could only get Finn in this package set because I would have liked just about anybody else. I mean, I don't know. I have all this disdain for all these characters I don't know yet, so me as a Star Wars fan, I guess. But there you go. There's the figure. There's Finn with his blaster. He's got some kind of a bent hand blaster in his hand. And he's giving you a look. But yeah, a lot of points of articulation, nice design, loose jacket, a really nice figure. Very good. Definitely worth the, like, think, $8 at this cost. I was really surprised at how relatively affordable some of these action figures were comparatively to some things I've bought recently. So that's pretty cool. I think I want to save this for later. I'll save this one for later.
I've still been careful that I picked up in here.
Why don't you give me that one?
That one?
Yeah, that one.
Okay.
So this is cool. This is the Ken doll model, as I call it, of the First Order Stormtrooper, who are fucking sick. Like, wow, they're amazing. They just did such a good job of making the First Order Stormtrooper look like a Stormtrooper, but, like, be updated and new at the same time,
yeah.
You know, of being interesting and evocative of the old Stormtrooper, but of also being, I don't know, they just did a really good design job. Like, I really like the design on the new Stormtroopers because they feel new. You can definitively tell what kind of Stormtrooper they are. These were $15, I think, which is, like, not expensive for something this size, if it has, like, any points of articulation at all, which I'm hoping it will. So there he is. He's super cool. He's really tall. It does look like he's going to have at least a couple points of articulation, though not as many as the Black Series figure I just looked at. Cut his blaster loose. So that is his new E11, which I love the look of, the white and black. I mean, it's very evocative of the old Blastech E11, but, you know, has the same magazine structure, but has the unfolding, like, forward grip, which is interesting. They have a forward grip, but not an unfolding stock, unless that's intended to be an unfolding stock in some capacity. But, like, it's really cool. It looks very, very much like the old E11, but cool and updated. Which I'm totally down for. Alright, so there he is. Arms articulate in one way, just up and down. Legs articulate just a little bit, so he kind of looks like Frankenstein now.
No!
And then head doesn't move. But still, would look really cool on, like, a shelf or something. Or, you know, like, in a 10-year-old kid's hand. Which is, like, probably what all this stuff is made for, but nobody's judging me. He holds his blaster sideways. I guess maybe I put his blaster in his other hand. Is he a lefty? Oh my god, he's a lefty. So, it's them! Blast them! It's pretty cool. He kind of holds it gangsta style. And
he does.
Looks like he's going for a kill shot. You know. And then he's got a little bit of brown stuff on his head. But otherwise, like, the armor looks a little scuffed, which I imagine is actually, like, scuffing from... And his knee plates don't line up perfectly. But, you know what? It's a big figure, and it will look good on my shelf. I'll put him next to Captain Kirk. I have a Captain Kirk that looks just like that. How about we do this set?
Okay.
This is the last of our starships. And so this is the titanium set that is pretty interesting. It's actually not very exciting initially, because it just has a regular TIE fighter, a regular X-Wing, the Millennium Falcon, yawn, but then it has the reason that I bought this set, and it's hard to see with the glare, but that is Poe Dameron's black X-Wing, which is so cool. That's actually the one I have the model of coming in the mail as well, from Lego. I have to cut my fingers open.
Do you need help, Eric?
No, got it. I'm just trying not to cut my fingers open. So, should be able to get a better look at it now. So there you go. That's Poe Dameron's black X-Wing up there, which I'm super excited about. So, I will open that one up first, since the rest of them are just small figures of, like, things we've seen before. I don't really feel the need to, get into that. This set was a little expensive. But holy crap, that thing is super freaking awesome. So, Man, that is super duper cool right there. This looks awesome and amazing and a lot of really cool detail, and I really love the color scheme, black and orange. That just looks really neat. I'm super down to that. Oh, you can compare the two, it and the regular resistance one right next to each other. So those are both pretty cool. Excuse me. All right, and then I don't know the rest of those. How about this one?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so in the same black series that we have Finn in, excuse me, sorry, we have Kylo Ren, who's very cool. All right, you can see, you know, I backlit myself. That was really foolish. By putting the lighting behind the camera that could reflect off of everything. But it does provide nice lighting when I'm not doing shiny stuff, so... So there we go, let's try that. Ooh, Kylo Ren, that's pretty darn cool. And his crossguard saber, which I hated at first, but I am growing more and more fond of as time goes on. I gotta figure out how to get it out without breaking it. Or bending it, especially. There we go. I can free his arm. Oh, dog. So feel that. It's made of actual cloth.
Whoa.
Is that pretty cool?
That
or what?
That is really cool.
So check that out. That is fucking awesome. Kylo Ren's... I keep looking down at the phone because I'm looking at the preview. So instead of looking at the camera, I'm looking at the phone like a freaking idiot. Sorry, I didn't realize I was doing that all day. You can pull his hood off if you want to and... See his mask goes all around the side of his face. But yeah, that's a really cool figure. And he's like, use the force. And choking people, probably. And then you can look up under his skirt if you want to. You can look under his skirt if you want to. You can leave your friends behind. So that is an awesome figure. I'm super excited about that one. Alright. Alright, so... Our last of the actual... No, maybe our second to last of the actual action figures. This is Daisy Ridley's character, Rey. And she comes with, like, a jetpack and a bag, apparently. Which is, like, her, Darth Vader, and the First Order Stormtrooper all have... It's interesting to me that Darth Vader is so heavily represented in all the different action figure packs. I mean, so is Boba Fett and Chewbacca in some places. I know because they're popular characters. But it's just really, really interesting to me how frequently I'm seeing Darth Vader as part of major collections of character packs for Force Awakens. I'm wondering if that's telling of the idea that maybe Vader is back in the next movie.
Oh, so all of the, like, these things?
Mm-hmm.
They tell you, the other two figures you need to get the other pieces, and yep. Then you can combine some of the other stuff. I get it now.
Yeah. That way you can't just buy one figure that you want.
Right, you have to buy one.
So this is Rey.
Mm-hmm.
And we got a little sticket for her, her gaffy stick, or whatever this is supposed to be.
And show off her hair in the back. It's really
oh,
pretty.
It's got this little bun back there. That's kind of cool. And then she has a little bag, which is whatever bag she's going to carry on Jakku. And then this is her jetpack that is also going to be like the top part of like an E-Web blaster that if you bought the First Order Stormtrooper and the Darth Vader figure for the other components. Which is kind of cool. She doesn't have a hole in her back to equip it with. So she can't like wear a random jetpack like on her back. There, she's got her stick, and I don't really understand how to put on her. Here, why don't you work on that, and give me that. So, the last of my really cool figures is the same Ken doll style of Kylo Ren that I had the First Order Stormtrooper in, which is pretty cool. So I'm gonna open that up right now. Better cut the sides. Would help if I remember how to open basic packages. And once again, it looks like he's got some cloth material, so that's pretty cool. Oh, no, never mind. But he does have his lightsaber, which is really cool. They did a really fabulous job. It's interesting to me that the, like, on the packaging, we see the obvious design that his crossguard saber is the crossguard saber. So, like, it has two little holes on either side where the extra parts come out. But in all the toys, they've made it less of a crossguard and more of, like, a flamberge. Where, like, that, you know, there's, like, this eruption of energy. It's really interesting, the different design choice they made there. So he, once again, has no... He's a little bit of leg articulation, which is cool because, like, his legs are, like, inside of his robe is, like, one piece. But he has this leg articulation, then he holds out his one hand for the Force, and his other hand is supposed to hold his lightsaber. So he can be like... But I'll pose him kind of like that, probably, which looks pretty sick. What do you think?
Yeah. Awesome. I got her bag figured out.
Oh, it's a backpack. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's really cool. Backpack, and she's got her stick.
Yeah, the straps go around, and there's little pegs in the back. And then there's the thingy.
I don't know how the thingy doesn't seem to attach to her.
Yeah.
It's just a thingy.
I don't know if you
wanted
to show it.
Oh, I know. Okay. So yeah, there's Kylo Ren. Alright, so I think we got one or two more things. Gonna do the clothes?
Yeah.
And I'm sorry we don't have BB-8 or... Oh, here's the other Finn. He was under my leg. So hang on, let me do him first. So here he is. That's our small Finn figure. Which is pretty cool. And I'll open him up. I didn't mean to lose him. It was an accident.
You're just silly.
Okay, I'm kind of close enough this time. Alright, so hold up. So, actually, I'm going to move the camera just a little bit, move it back just a little, and then I'll put the preview up here in front of the camera, so I should have done that in the first place. That would have been so much better instead of having me staring at the floor the entire frickin' video. Oh, well. What are you going to do? So he comes with a little robot base, so who do you have to collect for him? You have to collect the Flame Trooper and Constable Zuvo. I don't know what a Constable Zuvo is. Probably a new character from the movie. But, yeah, so here is little John Boyega. And he has a hole in his back for one of these things to connect to him, but this one can't because it's too big. Like, it doesn't go on him. Yeah, this one isn't... Oh no, maybe it can. I just cut the instructions in half. It's a little, like, transformer, it just kind of looks like.
It's cute.
Oh, okay, I get it. So it goes on... like that, and then, like... pops over his shoulders to form, like, War Machine-style death cannons. You know, like, holy crap. That's impressive. Or maybe it goes on, like, the other way. And goes. Oh, yeah, I think that actually is better. I think... No, maybe, well, all right, now they're mortars. Now he's got mortars on his back. So, holy crap. Because those things have, like, little magazine, like, ammunition magazines. And so, like, those are definitely mortars. So, and then give me the one off of Poe Dameron. Yeah, pull it off his back. It's not supposed to connect, but it totally can. giving him wings too. So now he's like, we can do bombing runs like sideways. It's hilarious.
You're silly.
Hey, will you grab me the Lego set and the Star Destroyer over there, please? So this is one of the ones that I opened first because I'm super excited about. That is the New Order Star Destroyer. And I'm so upset that I haven't seen any other models of this anywhere because it looks really cool. Very Eclipse-like. Definitely evocative of some of those models. So that is freaking sick. And then one of the other things I bought myself recently, this is not a Force Awakens toy, but it is badass. This is the Star Wars Rebels prototype TIE Advanced that the Inquisitor flies. And I assume at least at one point Darth Vader does something with it, though I didn't get a Darth Vader toy. I didn't get a Darth Vader minifigure. I got a Command Officer minifigure, I got an Inquisitor minifigure, and then inside the cockpit, there's a Imperial pilot in there. I don't know if you can see that. And then it can, if you hold it, it can fire little ray blasts, which is awesome. So this set is really, really pretty. Lego sets are expensive these days, but man, like, it's just so well designed. It's got such cool details and little decals on it, and I just really, really like it. Like, that thing is so cool. All right, so there's that. Now on to the clothes. So me and Sarah both got, I have this shirt on that I have here, so let me see if I can adjust that over my chest. Star Wars Force Awakens Kylo Ren. It's actually not the shirt I wanted. I picked this one up thinking it was a different shirt, which I didn't know they had in my size, so I'm going to go back and get it. And then me and Sarah both got this shirt. She got one in a small size. I ordered one in a larger size. Does that show up on the preview? Mm-hmm. So that is really, really cool. We love that shirt. Like, that's freaking awesome. It would be cool if it was the New Order symbol, though I don't like the New Order symbol that much comparatively. And then I got this shirt, which is, oh man, holy cow, that shirt is really, really, really cool. I just, like, I love, I can't help it, I love the fucking Empire, like, you know, whenever I have the option Rebels or Imperials, I'm always like, Jedi are cool, but Stormtroopers and Star Destroyers. Why I want to join the 501st. All right, that's cool. That's another shirt I got. And then I got this shirt. And then Sarah got, this sweater, this pullover sweater, which has got the Star Wars logo, the Imperial Rebel Alliance symbol, and then this X-Wing on it, which is really, really cool. These were on sale at Kohl's, and they were not super expensive. Like, the t-shirts were like $10, so. All right, and then last, but not least, is my non-Force FX, but totally awesome Saber Builders Kylo Ren set. Which is so cool. I love the Saber Builders set. They're customizable lightsabers that you can do all kinds of crazy and silly things with, like, lightsaber tritons and, you know, just like, a gun and, like, whatever you want. Lightsaber size. Like, that's interesting.
There's more images on the side, too.
And then this one is the regular lightsaber, and then it also has, like, a dagger end at the bottom, which is cool. So, yeah, random images on the side about other lightsabers you could saber build. What are the scissors? What did I do with the scissors?
I don't know. Am I sitting on
them? No. Gosh, we can't keep track of scissors for 5 seconds. I just can't see them past my big old legs. This is the Blade Builders manual, which explains. So you better look through that manual and tell me if there are important things I need to know. Pro tip, kids, don't actually have other people tell you about how to do the safety things with manuals, but unless you're me, in which case, totally do. She's a better reader than me anyway, I can't read.
To replace batteries.
Oh, it's really cool. I don't know if you can see that, but they have a very distinctive pattern on the outside of the blade that kind of represents the fiery unstableness of the Kylo Ren saber. It's just pretty darn neat. So I saw another one that had the actual collapsible sides in it that weren't just like removable. But I did not order. I did not grab that one because I did not need like three of them. I don't need Kylo Ren's
one
saber.
One time snap assemblage to extend flip wrist to retract manually push down. Light dagger does not light up.
This must be how you attach the light dagger.
Before you begin to play, move switch from 1 to 2 to activate full range of features.
Where's the switch?
I think right there, probably.
Alright, so here it is. A lot of actually really cool details on the shoddy and kind of interesting construction of the saber on there. And then the blade comes out, and then... You want to turn off some of the lights?
Yeah.
And you can see that lights up, and then... Cool noises. That's pretty neat. And then just get those. And then maybe the kitchen too. Because I can see the kitchen from here.
Have to wade through the sea of packaging.
Yeah, that's fair. Oh, that'll probably be good enough.
Oh, that's sweet.
It's...
The dog is so concerned.
What are you concerned about, dog? You sniffing the end of my lightsaber, bro?
Yeah.
Poke. He just lays down. What are you doing, bro? Poke. That's pretty cool. And then, yeah, so... That's our Force Friday. We got a whole bunch of cool shirts and toys and awesome stuff.
And we have $40 in Kohl's cash to go buy more shirts.
Yeah, yeah, well, there's definitely going to be more shirts. I'll do another video probably next weekend, which is going to be like all of the other stuff we're buying.
And the stuff coming in the mail.
Oh, yeah, yeah, like we got 2 Lego sets, the lightsaber, the Sphero, another shirt. Like, we got a lot of stuff coming in the mail. So this is what happens when the Kylo Ren saber has its light dagger on the back end, which is stupid but awesome. Oh, no! All right. See you guys later.